Hello everyone, welcome to my free online tutorial for the new SAT math section. The problem that you see on your screen right now is taken from the new SAT study guide, right? This is practice test 3, problem number 12, section 3, no calculator. Okay, so it gives you an equation and it says in the quadratic equation above, A is a non-zero constant. The graph of the equation in the xy plane is a parabola with vertex C, D, which of the following is equal to D? Okay? So you have to put this equation in vertex form, right? So this is my way of doing this. Well, I'll give you two methods. The first method is to complete the square, right, in order to arrive at the vertex form of the equation, right? So you complete the square. First of all, you use the FOIL method, right? So start with the x's and then 4, so you're going to have x times x plus 4 times x minus 2 times x plus negative 2 times positive 4. And all that will be multiplied to 8, right? So you're going to have a, which multiplies the parentheses expression, x squared plus 2x minus 8. And then you're going to complete the square, right? So you're going to complete the square by doing x squared plus 2x plus 2 divided by 2, and this thing is squared. And how do we know that? We use this 2 and we divided that by 2. We take a half of this, in other words, and we square the half, and then we subtracted the squared half, right? So whatever you add, you must subtract because it didn't exist there before, right? And then don't forget your negative 8 at the end, right? Because it still existed, right? So we would have a, and in the parentheses we would have x squared plus 2x plus 1, and we took out the squared half of this 2, right, coefficient. So we would have minus 1, right, because 2 over 2 is 1, and you square that, it's 1, but the negative is outside the parentheses, so it's negative still there. So negative 1 minus 8 would be negative 9, and remember, the negative 9 is still multiplied to a, right? So if you want to take these guys out, the a, the negative 8 and negative 1, you must multiply it to a. Make sure that it's not standing there by itself, right? So we're going to have plus negative 9 times a, right? I express it with a plus so that you would recognize the familiar vertex form, right? Because we could have had just negative 9a, but I wanted you to see it so that it's more comfortable for you to recognize the form, right? So plus negative 9 times a. So if we compress it, in other words, right, if we make it into a perfect vertex form, we would have a x plus 1, and this expression in the parentheses is squared, right, because if you expand it, you would have had x squared plus 2x plus 1, and then plus negative 9a stays there, and I marked it with red because you can see that it's a typical vertex form equation, y is equal to a constant, non-zero constant, times x minus h squared plus k, right? The h is the x coordinate of the vertex, right? And the k is the y coordinate of the vertex, right? So here the c is an x coordinate of the vertex, d is the y coordinate of the vertex. So they're saying which of the following is equal to d, the y coordinate of the vertex, and that is equal to k. And since I marked it with red, you can see that k is equal to negative 9a. So the correct answer choice is a. Okay, so now let's talk about the second method, and this method is actually talked about in the SAT study guide. So they're saying that you can find parabola zeros, right? So parabola zeros means the y values, the x values, sorry, that produce the y value of zero, right? So find the x values that make the parabola equal zero, right? Y is equal to zero. So that means that we would have x is equal to 2, because if you set 2, how do you make this thing 0? You can make it 0 by assigning this x value 2, and this second value, or this second value 4, right? Negative 4, because negative 4 plus 4 is 0, and 2 minus 2 is 0. So you can have either x is equal to 2 or x is equal to negative 4. Okay? So these are the two zeros. These are the two x values that produce the y value of 0. Okay? So now, when you find the zeros, and why do we need the zeros? We need the zeros because each parabola, when we talk about a parabola, it is symmetric with respect to a vertical line drawn through the vertex, right? So the vertex, the top or the bottom, whichever it is, in this case, well, A could be positive or negative. In any case, the vertex point, right, is right in the middle. It's the midpoint between the zeros, right? The midpoint between x is equal to 2 and x is equal to negative 4. And again, why? Because the parabola is symmetric with respect to its vertex point. Okay, so all around the vertex, it will be a mirror image of itself. Okay, so we find the midpoint of x is equal to 2 and x is equal to negative 4. And if you use the midpoint formula, you'll know that the x coordinate will be 2 plus negative 4, which will be negative 2, divided by 2. And that's going to give you x is equal to negative 1. And that's your c value, right? Because this is the x coordinate of the vertex, which is c. It's given as c here. So now all you need to do to find the value of d, the y coordinate of the vertex, is to plug in the c value that you found into the original equation, right? So when you do that, you're going to have negative 1 minus 2 times negative 1 plus 4. And this thing, multiplied to a, of course, will give you negative 3 times positive 3, which is negative 9. And negative 9 is still multiplied to a, and that's your d value, the y value, the y coordinate of the vertex. Okay?